Hello and welcome to this course on randomized algorithms. My name is Benny George Kenkareth. I am a faculty member at the Indian Institute of Technology, Guwahati, in the computer science department. So let us look at what this course is about. The title of the course is Randomized Algorithms. So randomized algorithms is a marriage between two very important concepts in mathematics or computer science, namely algorithms and randomness. Algorithms, broadly speaking, you can think of it as a sequence of instructions to accomplish a certain task. So when we say a sequence of instructions, we expect that these instructions are unambiguous, they're very clear. But often the instructions may not be of that kind. Okay, that is, in real life, instructions may be ambiguous. One can say that it is random in a certain sense. When we look at algorithms and when we program, we don't want those kind of things. That is, we want the answers to be deterministic. But often what we see is the algorithms have to make choices when executing a certain task. For example, when we are looking at sorting numbers, for the algorithm to run very nicely, the choice of which numbers to compare is very crucial. Okay, if it compares certain numbers initially, that might lead to an overall reduction in the number of comparisons made. So the algorithm is faced with multiple choices at each stage. Out of these choices, which choice does the algorithm make? So this is the essential problem that the algorithm designer faces. How does one resolve this choice? One could look deeply into the structure of the problem that one is looking at and then find out clever ways to exploit that structure. Or one could just choose in an arbitrary fashion. Okay, so this might look as madness at the onset, but we will later on see that there is method to this madness. Okay, that is precisely what is the study of randomized algorithms. Instead of making deterministic choices, often if we just make random choices, in an average sense, things could be rosy. So what all are the kind of problems for which this randomness helps? How do we measure the success of these methods? Of course, when we are using randomness, it might be the case that we might end up with incorrect answers. If you're willing to live with incorrect answers for some time, suppose the incorrectness can be measured, and if it can be kept very small, and if you are okay with small, very tiny amount of incorrectness, then we can, let us say, design good algorithms. Okay. That is, algorithms which will run faster than, let us say, the traditional deterministic algorithms. Okay. All of you must be familiar with the quicksort algorithm, which is an example of a randomized algorithm. That's an introductory example wherein the answer is always sorted, the answer is always correct. So even when we are using randomness, the final answer is usually correct. But there the trouble is, in some cases we could take very long time. For most of the random choices that we make, the expected running time or the actual running time will be reasonably small. Okay. So in this course we will study this interaction between randomness and algorithms. The textbooks for the course will basically be the randomized algorithm book by Motwani and Raghavan, and there's another book by Mitzenmacher and Eli Upfel, Probability and Computing. These are the main textbooks that we will be using for the course. Once again, I welcome you all to the course.